Grand Prix of Alabama winner Joseph Newgarden, center, celebrates on the podium with runner-up Ryan Hunter-Reay, left, and third-place finisher James Hinchcliffe. Butch Dill, AP, leads Alabama. Over his past 10 races, Joseph Newgarden has walked away the winner 5 times and in doing so, has written his own little Dr. Seuss rhyme. He's won races at a park, Gateway. He's won races in the dark, Phoenix. He's won races with no sweat, Mid-Ohio. He's won races where, at first, he wasn't a threat, Toronto. On Monday, he proved he can win races in the wet. After rain drenched and delayed the Honda Indy Grand Prix of Alabama Sunday, Mother Nature opened the skies again late during the resumption of the race on Monday at Barber Motorsports Park, but Newgarden was able to keep from sliding off and run away with his second victory of the season. Though the water made things tricky for Newgarden at the end, it may have been what preserved his victory. Heading into the day after leading the first 22 laps, Sunday, Newgarden and his number one team Penske crew, along with the rest of the field, were confronted by a fascinating conundrum: execute a two-stop strategy or try to make it to the checkered flag in one. The number one team elected to go with two stops, which wound up being a perfect decision when skies opened up, with about 15 minutes to go in the time race. That rain made it very nerve-wracking, Newgarden said after picking up the ninth victory of his career. I think for us, we did the only thing we could. We went to rain, tires, as soon as it intensified. We hit two. I think it was the right thing to do. Just because we're in the lead, we have the most to lose by not putting on reins early. Recap, how the Honda Indy Grand Prix of Alabama played out. Controversial decision, IndyCar allows teams to refuel before restart. Hinchcliffe, you were talking to a man who just wet himself. Newgarden was able to brake late in the race and slap on rain tires to deal with a that was losing traction every second. Meanwhile, his chief competitor for the win, Sebastian Bourdais, was hoping the rain would hold off long enough for him to seize what would have been his second victory of the season. Unfortunately for the Dale Coyne Racing with Vassar Sullivan driver, Mother Nature had other ideas. Bourdais, who wound up fifth after a drag race to the finish line with Scott Dixon, stayed out in the rain with slick tires as long as he could, but in the end, the risk of spinning out in wet conditions became too great. Bottom line, we beat Joseph, a frustrated Bourdais said after the race. It's that simple. But Mother Nature decided otherwise. We tried to stay out, and it bit us. Unfortunately, you can't predict what the weather is going to do, so you have to make a call, one way or the other, and we were on the wrong side of the fence today. We need the expletive luck to turn soon, because I'm getting real tired here. The last 3 weekends have not been kind to us. At least we're showing pace, but we're not getting the points for it. This one was particularly hard. Bourdais' bad luck was Newgarden's gain, however. Once Bourdais and Ryan Hunter-Reay, who was on a similar strategy, went to the pits, it was Newgarden's race to win, and he ran away with a 10-second victory. Andretti Autosports Hunter-Reay, a 2-time Barber winner, pitted before Bourdais and salvaged the day with a runner-up finish. Schmidt-Peterson Motorsports' James Hinchcliffe came in behind him, notching his first podium of the season. For Newgarden, the win was his third at Barber, though his record suggests that he's far from a road course specialist. The Tennessee native's most recent wins have come on a pair of short ovals, 2 road courses and a street course circuit. My hope is we get multiple wins at other S, and it's not just one place where people think you're good, Newgarden said. With his victory Monday, Newgarden recaptured the championship lead with 4 races in the books this season. His 158 points are 13 more than Alexander Rossi, who gambled longest on slick tires and finished 11th on Monday. Bourdais sits third with 119 points, the same number as Graham Rahal, who finished 7th. Ello writes for the Indianapolis Star, part of the USA Today Network.